Now we have the idea, means we have the knowledge regarding the DNA molecules, that we can easily say we have the characters from our parents. Means how we are received these characters from our parents through their chromosomes. Means that chromosomes merely made up with the DNA molecules. So indirectly, we have the DNA molecules of our parents. Because of that, we express the characters which are involved in our parents. So that concept nowadays we know, but on that time, no one scientist knows about the DNA is a genetic material. ನಮಗೆ ಇವಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಏನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಯಿಂದ ಬಂದಿರ್ತದ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಅದು ಎದ್ರ ಮುಖಾಂತರ? ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮುಖಾಂತರ. ಹೆಂಗ್ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬಂದಿರ್ತದ? ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ಬಂದಿರ್ತವ. ಯಾವಾಗ ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದ? ಗ್ಯಾಮೆಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಲೇಬೇಕು. ಕ್ರೋಮೋಸೋಮ್ಸ್ ಹಾಫ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಿರ್ತವ್. ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಗಳು ಬಂದಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದನೇ ನಾವು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಬಹುದು. ಅದು ಫಿಲ್ಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಸೆಲಿಬ್ರಿಟೀಸ್ ಗಳಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು, ಅವರು ಅಪ್ಪ ಮಗನ್ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲಂತಂದ್ರೆ ತಾಯಿ ಮಗಳ ರಿಲೇಷನ್ಶಿಪ್ ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದ್ರಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ವೇರಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಕಾಣಿಸುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಯಿಂದ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ಗಳಿಗೆ ಏನು ಒಂದು ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗಿತ್ತಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಓಕೆ, ಇವಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಗೊತ್ತ ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್, ಎಗ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ಲೇ. ಇದ್ರ ಒಳಗಡೆ ದಿ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಂಟೇನ್ಸ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಪರ್ಮ್ ಸೆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್, ಕಾರ್ಬೋಹೈಡ್ರೇಟ್, ಲಿಪಿಡ್ಸ್, ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಎಗ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಂಟೇನ್ಸ್ ದ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್, ಎನ್ಝೈಮ್ಸ್, ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ಸ್, ಸಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಬಟ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಝೈಗೋಟ್ ಆರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ದ ಲಿಪಿಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಟು ದಿ ಝೈಗೋಟ್, ಕಾರ್ಬೋಹೈಡ್ರೇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಟು ಝೈಗೋಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ವಾಸ್ destroyed by the different scientists after making their successful experiment. So let me see the some history behind the searching of DNA molecules. That already we know, in the year 1865 the inheritance concept or else the principles of inheritance mainly carried out by the Mendel, and later on 1869 the nuclein was discovered by the Mixer, and 1902 Walter Sutton and Theodore Bovary, they worked on the behavior of chromosomes, and in 1905 Thomas Hunt Morgan worked on the Drosophila melanogaster as a chromosome is a genetic material. But what happens in the year 1928, after these conclusion, after these milestone experiment in 1928, the scientists, they start to searching the genetic material. But several scientists worked on the discovery of chromosomes and also the DNA. There are a lot of scientists, they involving to searching the DNA and also the chromosomes, but they unable to answer the genetic material. They unable to answer this DNA is only the genetic material. So how that concept was taken by the different scientists? So let me see how they got the knowledge about the DNA molecule is the only one chemical which has the ability to transmit from one cell to other cell. One thing you have to remember, there was no other chemicals present inside the cell which has the ability to transmit from one cell to another cell. There was only one, that is the DNA molecule, which has the ability to transmit from one cell to other cell without changing their shape, without changing their structure, without changing their chemical structure. So do you got the point? Which type of DNA present inside the one cell, that DNA only can easily transmit to the other cell through the chromosomal behavior. This concept we will know nowadays, but on that time there was a no one scientist believes on this concept, because biology is mainly depends on the experiment. It is mainly believe on the experimental proof. So we are not considering about the theoretical explanation. We need the practical experiment, practical description regarding the any biological concept. So let me begin with the one experiment that was carried out by the one of the greatest scientists, the Frederick Griffith, in the year 1928. He started to demonstrate DNA is the only material which is transmitted from one cell to another cell. So let me begin how he will perform his experiment. Okay. So you know tan experiment anna yav reeti madida. So how he conclude, how he conduct his experiment, why he choose the mouse, why he taken the injection, and what exactly he will made with. And that time what happens, the Frederick Griffith, he tried to searching the vaccine for Streptococcus pneumoniae. Streptococcus pneumoniae, it is one kind of bacteria which is responsible to cause the disease called as an pneumoniae disease. What do you mean by the pneumonia disease? Pneumonia, it is one kind of disease. It mainly affects to the lungs of an human beings. So as nowadays, the coronavirus infect to the our lungs. Like that, pneumonia, it is one of the disorder which mainly affects to the lungs by the bacteria, which is called as a Streptococcus pneumoniae. So do you got the point? Streptococcus pneumoniae, ಇದು ಒಂಥರದ್ದು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ. ಈ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮೋನಿಯಾ ಅನ್ನುವಂತ ಒಂದು ರೋಗವನ್ನ ಬರಸ್ತದ. ಈ ನಿಮೋನಿಯಾ ರೋಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗತ್ತಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲಾಯ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ. ಈ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲಾಯ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತವೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಅನ್ನ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಡೈಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹೊರಗಡೆಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲಾಯ್ ಒಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಏನ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದು ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಡಿಪಾಸಿಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಡಿಪಾಸಿಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ರೆಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ನಿಮೋನಿಯಾ ಡಿಸಾರ್ಡರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದಿ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಅಲ್ವಿಯೋಲಾಯ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ ಲಂಗ್ಸ್, ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟಿ ಇನ್ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್. ಇಟ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಕಾಸ್ ಟು ಡೆತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ particular organism. So wherever we find the Streptococcus pneumonia inside the organism, that leads into death of particular organism due to the pneumonia. Pneumonia, it mainly destroys the lungs. Lungs is a major part of our body which is helpful for the respiration process. Do you got the point? Okay, so if you know this concept, the next later concept you can easily catch. So let me see what exactly he will did. He choose the Streptococcus pneumoniae, that is one kind of the bacteria. He grow this bacteria on a culture plate. Culture plate means what? That already you are familiar with. So this is a petri dish. We are already using our laboratory for pollen germination experiment. This petri dish mainly filled with the chemicals. Chemicals are the one of the substance which support to the growth of bacteria. When this petri dish filled with the chemical, that is called as a culture, that is called as culture media. Culture media antandre ee petri dish id olagadege naavu ondishtu chemicals galanna tagondu aa chemicals galanna petri dish olagade haaktivi. ಪೆಟ್ರಿ ಡಿಶ್ ಅನ್ನ ಹಾಕಿ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿರುವಂತ ಏನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ರೆಡ್ ಕಲರ್, ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಆ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ. ಈ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಗ್ರೋ ಆಗ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್, ಹಿ ಗ್ರೋ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಆನ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್. ಹಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದಟ್ there are two types of bacteria grow on that culture. Aa culture mele erdu tarada bacteria grow agirthu. Aa erdu tarada bacteria heng grow agirthu nodre, see, so these are the bacteria which are grow on the culture plate. Culture plate mele bacteria yav reeti grow agirthav antandre, so neevu illi nodabodu. So now you got the point. Let come to the which type of bacteria he found on the culture plate. So when he started to grow the bacteria on culture plate, he found the two types of bacteria. One bacteria, they form the smooth colony around their cell because of the mucus coat. That mucus coat mainly contains the polysaccharide. Polysaccharide is one of the chemicals which makes the bacteria to the virulent. Next one, and another one. Another one, he found the rough colony bacteria because they don't have the any mucus coat on their surface because polysaccharide coat is absent. Due to absence of polysaccharide coat, that is called as a non-virulent. Means they don't cause the pneumonia. Here they cause the pneumonia. So now let listen carefully. When Grippy grow the Streptococcus pneumonia on culture plate, he found two types of bacteria. Which one? The S strain bacteria. Another one is an R strain bacteria. So let we see. What is the differences between S strain bacteria and as well as the R strain bacteria? In S strain bacteria, what it mainly indicates here, S indicates the smooth colony forming bacteria because they form the mucus coat around their cell. Why? They have the polysaccharide coat. Due to polysaccharide coat, they become virulent, means they are poisonous, which are responsible for causing the disease called as a pneumonia. And in next one, the R strain bacteria, here R stands for rough colony forming bacteria because they don't have the mucus coat on their cell due to absence of polysaccharide coat. So they are considered as a non-virulent, means they don't cause the disease. So here, which one is lethal? Means which one is poisonous? S strain bacteria is poisonous. And R strain bacteria is a non-poison. Means they don't cause the any disorders. Now, can you tell me, I will ask the one question. If I inject S strain to your body, you will affect with disease or not? ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾವನ್ನ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ನಿಮೋನಿಯಾ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೋ ಇಲ್ಲೋ? ಬರ್ತಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಎಸ್ ಅಂತ ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ, ಬರಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನೋ ಅಂತ ಟೈಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ನಾ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು ಯಾವ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ? ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಆನ್ಸರ್. ಎಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪಾಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ಬೈ ಚಾನ್ಸ್ ನಾನು ಏನಾದರೂ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾವನ್ನ ನಿಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೋ ಇಲ್ಲ? ಇವಾಗ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾವನ್ನ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ನಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊರಿ. ನಿಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ನಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೋ ಇಲ್ಲ? ನೋ. ಓಕೆ, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, then you will easily understand this overall experiment. So do you got the differences between S strain and R strain? Nimage S strain matte R strain bagge gothaita? Okay, so now already we got the point. While we are injecting the virulent bacteria to the mouse, the mouse will be die. Mouse is die. Okay, so that point we know. So when we inject the S strain bacteria into the mouse, mouse is die. When we inject R strain bacteria into the mouse, mouse did not die. Mouse sayalla. Okay, idontu gothaytala virulent matte non virulent antandre gothaytu. Okay, let me quickly understand the Griffith experiment step by step. So there are mainly four steps in Griffith experiment. Let me discuss one by one. So first step, in first step, what happens? He inject the rough strain bacteria that is considered as a non-virulent into the mice. Mice is live. Mice did not die because rough strain bacteria is a non-virulent. Means R strain bacteria, they don't have the ability to cause the disease because polysaccharide coat is absent, means they are the non-virulent. So mice is live. In the next step, now what he did, he inject the smooth strain bacteria that is considered as a virulent into the mice. Obviously, smooth strain bacteria, they cause the disease because they have the smooth polysaccharide coat around their cell. So here mice is died. In third step, what he did, let's see. Here, he heat killed the smooth strain bacteria. Means he heat the smooth strain bacteria. While heating the smooth strain bacteria, do you know what happened? He destroyed the polysaccharide coat present around their cell. He destroyed the polysaccharide, but he did not destroy their DNA molecule. Just try to understand. Now what happened? So due to absence of polysaccharide coat, that smooth strain bacteria will become turns into the R strain bacteria, like a rough strain bacteria. Now he injects heat killed smooth strain bacteria into the mice. Now mice is live. Mice did not die. Why it should can die? Because in the R strain bacteria, they don't have the polysaccharide coat. Let's see what happens in the fourth step. In the fourth step, there is a surprisingly one situation and one condition will be happen with that mice. What that one? He mixed the rough strain with the heat killed S strain bacteria. Now just we can understand. Rough strain bacteria, it is also the non-virulent. And heat killed S strain bacteria also the non-virulent. While mixing of these both non-virulent bacteria and inject into the mice, now mice is die. He got a shock. Why mice is die? He concluded that while mixing of rough strain and S strain bacteria, the heat killed S strain bacteria, something had transferred to the R strain bacteria. Andre avu yen tilkotana antandre heat killed madiruvanta smooth strain bacteria yavdo ondu material anna R strain bacteria ke en maditantandre kottada. So adakkagi R strain bacteria nu kuda smooth strain bacteria aage convert agide. But ava DNA irthadantana helala. He don't know about the DNA, and even he don't give the explanation regarding that was the DNA which was transmitted from heat killed S strain to the R strain bacteria. He suggests that there is something, one material which was present inside the S strain that only transferred to the R strain. So due to this reason, he gives the name of the Frederick Griffiths transforming principle. The name of transforming principle that comes by this technique. So here, in the first step, what happens? Mice is live. But, okay. The conclusion, total conclusion regarding the Griffith experiment. In second step and fourth step, mice is die. Okay, in second step, why mice is die? Because of the smooth strain bacteria, that is the virulent in condition that will die, okay. But in fourth step, what happened? There he mixed the rough strain and also the heat killed S strain. The both bacteria are the non-virulent in characteristics, but still mice is die because of the transforming principle. He suggests that there is something material is present inside the heat killed bacteria that was transferred to the R strain. Now, non-virulent R strain bacteria also converted into the virulent S strain bacteria. The final conclusion of this experiment. Living R bacteria transformed into the deadly S bacteria by unknown. that is called as an heritable substance. Even he don't know about the DNA, he don't know about the genetic material. He suggests that there was something is transformed. So that's why we can call it as a transforming principle. So are you understood the mechanism and are you understood the overall experiment? This is asked for 5 marks. So while once you are understand, you can write within a 1 minute overall concept. ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬರೀ ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ನಿಮಿಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಹೇಳಿ ನೀವು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು, ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು. ಇವು ಎರಡೂ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಗೊತ್ತಿತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಕ್ವಶನ್ಸ್ ಕೇಳಿ ನೀವು ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಹೇಳಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು, ಎಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. Okay, shall I move the next experiment? That is biochemical characterization of transforming principle carried out by the every macleod and macaulay. One thing you have to remember, if this session is over, please stay there only. Again, I will restart and I will rejoin you people. Sorry, understood? ee session enadru mugilike bantandre neevellu hogbedri, illa irri, nanu matte again start martini. ಸೊ ಬಯೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋಣವಾ? ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ ರಿಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು, ನೀವು ಎಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬಯೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕಂಡಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ 3 ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್, ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅವರಿ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಲೋಯ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕಾರ್ಟಿ. So how you could remember the biochemical characterization of transforming principle, the name of scientist anna neevu yav riti nenapittukoltiri nodli, MAM, that means MAM, first to M, macleod, next to Avery, next to McCarty, MAM. Okay, I am not bother about the boys, why they are not joined, boys are not joined, why I don't want to the reason. Okay, yak join agille avaru, boys yavaglu join agala, boys baala talent adara. Okay, nan illi helta irudu talent yar illa avrige ashta helagutini, boys baala talent adara adukku join agilla, join yar agillalla avr bage bit bidre. Okay, ha nodre, biochemical characterization of transforming principle carried out by the 3 important scientists, Avery, Macleod and McCarty. Okay, what they did, avaru yen martaru antandre, let's see another one important story behind the biochemical characterization of transforming principle. As we are discussed in earlier experiment that was conducted by the Griffith, so while he injecting the mixture of R strain and smooth strain bacteria, while he mixing the rough strain with the heat killed S strain bacteria, he inject into the mice is die. From that mice, they take the blood sample. While taking the blood sample from that mice, so they perform the experiment whether that is the DNA, that is the RNA, or else that is the protein which is transferred from heat killed S strain to the R strain bacteria. So notably, ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಆಗಲೇನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸತ್ತಿತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದು ಸ್ಮೂತ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್, ಹೀಟ್ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಟೀರಿಯಾ ಮಿಕ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಲಿಗೆ ಇಂಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಇಲಿ ಏನಾಗಿತ್ತು ಹೇಳ್ರಿ, ಸತ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಆ ಇಲಿ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಆ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಯಾವ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅದ, ಯಾವ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅದ, ಅದನ್ನ ಅವ್ರು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಯೆಲ್ಲೋ ಕಲರ್, ಅದ್ರ ಪಕ್ಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೀಟ್ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಇವಾಗ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಅವರು ಹೀಟ್ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾರೆ, ತಗೊಂಡ ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಒಂದು ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿ ಒಂದ್ ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಕೊಡ್ರಿ, ನೀವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅದರ ಒಳಗಡೆ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರ್ತದ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಸೆಲ್, ದಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಶುಡ್ ಫಿಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ other chemicals along with the DNA molecules, like a protein, like a carbohydrate, like a enzymes, like a RNA molecules. Now, what they will do, they will select the heat killed S cell inside the test tube. In that test tube, they will add one kind of enzymes one by one to remove the other chemicals. Just you think. So this heat killed S cell that mainly filled with DNA, RNA, carbohydrate, proteins. Okay. So now what they will do? They will add the protease enzyme. While adding the protease enzyme, they remove the protein. Then next, they add the RNase enzyme. They remove the RNA molecule. They add the DNase enzyme. They remove the DNA molecule. Like that, they use the one kind of enzymes. These enzymes can remove the particular chemicals which are present inside the heat killed S cells. Okay, in first step, What they will remove? They remove the lipids and the sugar molecule by the centrifugation process or else by the other different physiological function. Illodile nimage melgade test tube kanasta idiya, from this test tube they removed the lipids and sugar molecule, and here there is an one test tube, the first step ig bani, they add the proteinase enzyme. Yav enzyme add martara? Proteinase enzyme anna add martara. While adding proteinase enzyme, they easily remove the protein, means that sample not contains the protein molecule. Our sample olagade protein molecule irangila, but DNA molecule irutada. Avaru yen martara andre proteinase anna haki protein anna aste horak tegitaru. And then next, that sample mix with the R cells. Next yen martara helidre adana R cells anna add martara. They will add R cells into that sample and they inject into the mice. Again they inject into the mice, this mixture inject into the mice. Now what happens, mice is die. Why mice is die? Because they have the DNA molecule. We are not removed the DNA. Next comes to the next step. In second step, yellow color no RNA antadal ali nodi, here they add the RNase enzyme to remove the RNA molecule. But in this condition, protein is also present, DNA is also present. They remove only the RNA molecule. So now that sample again add with the R cells. R cells an add martha, and next inject into the mice. Matte mice ig inject martha, mice is also die. Ivagnu kuda mice enagutte helri site. Next third step ig bari, here they add DNase enzyme. While adding DNase enzyme, they destroy the all DNA molecules which are present inside that sample, and that sample mix with the rough strain bacteria and inject into the mice. Now you tell me,